up till now, what I've been doing is focusing mainly on the more specific aspects of working with text. And what I mean by that is we've applied text to a curve of a known radius or a known size, or we've drawn various lines and vectors here and there and applied that text to those curves. And if you missed my earlier videos on that, I'll put another card up here to take you back to part one of this series. But today I'm going to focus on something that's a little bit more freeform, a little bit more, you know, fluid and less regimented and less defined, because sometimes you just don't need a specific radius. You don't need a specific measurement. You just want to go for what looks good. And VCarve gives you the tools that you need to do that, to apply text to a curve that for those cases where you just want it to quote unquote look good. So I'll go back over here into my draw text and do the things that basically you've been seeing me do so far. We're going to use the Times New Roman font, and I'm going to use my standard good old this is, and then hard return sample text. And I've got my text height set at 3/4 inch, anchored at X0, Y0, and we'll go ahead and apply that. Close this to get out of it. Once again, I'm going to move this just a little bit down here to give myself some room up here to work with. Then get out of the move function, just select the text, and once again break the two lines, break the block into two lines. So I have one line of text here, one line of text here. Now I'm doing this basically to show you that not everything has to be that specific. Now I can just move this up here to the top. And yeah, it's a little bit too close to the top, so let me bring this down here about like so. Just kind of move it to where it's not exactly centered, but it gives me enough room to put something else up around in here. Then I'm going to take this text here, move it up just above my X0, Y0. I'm going to come over here, select it rather, come over here to edit text spacing and curve. Now we've used this before in kerning and adjusting the spacing in between the letters, but it has another function that's more free form when you want to apply text to a curve. So I'll go ahead and click that icon, and if you notice what my text here, I've got a green dot, green square on the bottom, a green square on the top, and this white transparent square in the center. Now you see my cursor has got the T there, just to remind me that I'm working with text. And if I bring the cursor up in between two letters, you'll see that it changes to a V on one side, letter A on the other side, and that little plus sign down below the letter V. Now if I bring that plus sign over the white square, it gives me the four-way arrow, which will let me move it around if I click and hold and drag. But it's when I get over here to this green square, my cursor, that little plus sign is in that green square, but my cursor changes to an arc and with an upward arrow. And using that, I can just click on my mouse, holding down the left button, and drag it upwards and apply my text to a curve right there. I'm not drawing any extra vectors. I'm not doing anything else. I'm just kind of eyeballing it until it looks like something I want to work with right here. Now, and I think I can work with that as it is. Now, if you notice, when I moved this text upward, the bottom green square disappeared. It's because this green square will only let me, this top green square will only let me work in two directions, and that is up from flat horizontal, and then I can drag it back down and return it to horizontal. And once I get back down to perfectly horizontal, my other green square arrives. But it won't let me push down. I'm clicking and I'm pushing and it won't let me do it. If I want to drag this text downwards, I come to this one and you see the arc is facing the other direction and the arrow is facing the other direction. Click and drag it down this way. And you'll see that the text, the letters separate and everything to accommodate the turn. The arc, excuse me. And you can still move this curved text around to anywhere you want to move it to. I'm going to hold down Control-Z to undo that move. But much like the other green square, it will only allow me to push it back up to the horizontal position. It will not let me push up from the bottom. So you're pulling the text upwards or pulling the text downwards if you use these green squares here. And they're real effective if you just want to play a little bit and make a simple arc without a whole lot of figuring out how much of a radius do I need, what kind of length do I need, things of that nature. Now you'll also notice, let me bring that back down to flat horizontal, I've got nothing out here on the edges, but the minute I lift up from straight horizontal, I suddenly have red squares up here and blue squares down here. What these do is they help me adjust the arc that I've drugged my text up to. Like if I go down to the blue square down here, click and drag, see how the arc, the radius of the arc is changing. It's not moving any of the letters or characters in the center. It's just bringing the ends of the characters down, more so on the right side than on the left. I can come over here to the left and do the same thing, and it's dragging that down as well. So it's basically to increase the arc from the edges without changing around in the center. By the same token, we come over here to the red, and you'll see how my cursor changes to the arrow. By clicking and moving this, I'm able to rotate that text around an imaginary center that we have never drawn. And I can bring it back around to vertical, bring it back around this size, and so long as I keep my finger on that left arrow, or excuse me, on that left mouse button, I can drag this around. I can even still come back in here, make it a little bit tighter, and then drag around that center. Then I still have, this is all within that same tool, I still have the capability of zooming in, kind of adjusting the spacing on my letters here and there, to make it all look a little smoother. Then change my radius slightly and when I get everything set the way I like it, just come back over, click my standard selection tool, we're all set and ready to go. And grab this, move it, then I still have room for artwork over here, artwork over there, artwork down here. It's just a simple way of curving your text in a more free-form manner without worrying about what radius or drawing vectors or how to get back into node editing or any of those essentials that are used with the other methods. And again, that's just simply select the text, go over here to edit text, spacing, and curve, and play around with it. So that's an easy way to kind of play around with your text and wrap it around a curve in a more free-form manner without worrying about drawing extra vectors or taking measurements or what have you. So I'm going to go ahead and call that the end of this video. If you got anything out of it, consider giving me a thumbs up down below. Whether you subscribe to my channel or not, thank you very much for watching. Y'all take care.